It is said that smart people learn from their mistakes while wise people learn from mistakes of others. This is Steve Hine of Hine Wealth and Tax Solutions. Welcome to the 2020 Hindsight Report, where we try to learn from the mistakes of others to give you and your family a more secure financial future. In this episode, we'll be talking about the mistakes that people make with regards to dealing with Medicare. It's important to explore all your options for medical insurance before age 65. You need to calculate how much you spend on medical, dental, and vision expenses before you get to Medicare age in order to make an informed choice. The other thing you want to do while working is explore saving money in a health savings account, which could enable for the money in this account to grow and come out income tax free. The average couple is going to spend $285,000 out-of-pocket healthcare costs, which includes deductibles, co-pays, and medical expenses not covered by Medicare. This number does not include enormous potential long-term care expenses, dental, or the premiums paid for Medicare for higher income couples. You want to make Medicare choices with the rest of your life in mind. Once you turn age 65, you're eligible for Medicare and cannot be denied coverage for pre-existing conditions. So it's important to make wise decisions because medical underwriting can be required in changing coverage in later years. It'll be essential for you to make some key informed decisions as you approach your 65th birthday. You first need to decide whether you should apply for original Medicare, Part A, B, an optional Part D, and a Medigap plan, or a Medicare Advantage plan. Part A generally covers inpatient care in hospitals and skilled nursing facility care. Part B generally covers services from doctors and other qualified healthcare providers. Part C, also known as Medicare Advantage, is like an HMO or PPO that combines Part A and B in one network of healthcare providers. Medicare Advantage plans typically also include costs of prescription drugs that are covered under Part D. They also include extra coverage for services like vision care, dental care, and/or wellness services that are not covered by original Medicare. The bad news is you could be ultimately restricted on the types of doctors and health professionals you'd be able to use. It's recommended to see if the doctors you want to see are in these plans. It's also important to note that if you choose a Medicare Advantage plan, you might not be able to switch to an original Medicare plan in the future if your health or circumstances change. Part D helps the cost of prescription drugs run by Medicare-approved private insurance companies that follow rules set by Medicare. But if you want to enroll a Medicare Advantage plan, you most likely won't need to buy a separate policy for Part D benefit. It's important to look at the particular prescription drugs you're using and where you live to get an idea as to whether it makes sense to have a plan and what type to get. As we have seen, many decisions need to be made in considering the best plan for you in navigating Medicare options. It's important to make the best decision up front because sometimes there are no do-overs. This has been a 2020 Hindsight Report, where we try to learn from the mistakes of others to give you and your family a more secure financial future. If you're interested in learning more about the subject and how it might apply to individual circumstances, give us a call or click the link below to make an appointment. Thank you for joining us.